Today is cyber threats in cloud computing, and this is topic of subject cloud computing for business. The subject code is KMBIT03. Okay, so for further study you may refer following references. First is your textbook, second is reference book, and the rest are some good blogs about the topic. Okay, so first we will discuss about various security threats. Like first is this data breaches. So if you talk about this cloud computing, the data breach can be the main goal of an attack through which the sensitive information such as health related issues, okay, or health related information, financial information, personal identity, intellectual and other related information is viewed, stolen or used by an unauthorized user comes under the category of data breaches. Okay, so what are the various remediation regarding this data breaches? So if you talk about remediation, so these are some list of remediation, like analyze data protection during design and runtime. Okay, and next is organization must restrict access to data and maintain adherence to industry standards and compliance. Means you should ensure that password protected entry or login credentials to the cloud users so that no one can see others' data. Okay, so implementation of strong API, application program interface access control, should be there to avoid such type of data breaches. Next is the environment and infrastructure should be designed to restrict access and monitor traffic. Organization must encrypt and protect data in transit. In transit means if you are transferring data from one place to another place, then you should use this cryptographic technique. Okay, encrypt that data and then send. Okay, so that you can protect your data from this data breaches type of activities. So next is implement backup and retention strategies. So these are some of the remedies that you should take in care while dealing with such type of while dealing against such type of activities like data breaches. Okay, so next is next type of threat is insufficient identity, credentials and access management. Okay, what is insufficient identity? Basically, security threats may occur due to inadequate protection of credentials. An unauthorized user might read, modify and delete data or release a malicious software. Okay, so you should I think you should have a proper access control over there, as well as you should doubly check, or you should deploy their multi-level security mechanism to restrict such type of activities like insufficient identity or credentials or access management. Okay, so what are the remediations regarding this point? Means insufficient identity, credentials and access management. So these are some remediations, like security awareness should be provided to contractors, third party users and employees. Okay, next is use of two factor authentication. As I have told earlier that you should apply two factor or three factor or multi factor identifications authentication techniques. Okay, should be implemented to secure your account. Okay, next is organization must identity and access rights to detect violations. Okay, so you must continuously work towards such type of unauthorized activity, and I think you should take the preventive measures regarding such type of activity. Next is segregate accounts based on the business needs. Next is the data owner should restrict the internal corporate and customer, means tenant user account credentials. So these are some of the remediation that you should take while dealing with such type of activity, like insufficient identity or credentials or access management is there in your system, cloud-based, cloud-enabled system. Okay, next is insecure interface and API. API is what? Application programming interface. So cloud service providers expose a set of software users, interfaces and or application programming interface that organizations use to manage and interact with the cloud services. Okay. So moreover, customers and third party users often offer services to their customers through these interfaces. Like an unauthorized user may access and reuse these APIs or passwords. Okay. Generally, we use cookies. Okay. Or generally cookies stores information regarding your login. Okay. So you should, I think, take a backup of these cookies and delete it on the basis of time to time, so that somebody else could not access such type of cookies to access your passwords basically. So they may transmit content, get authorization and logging capabilities. Like nowadays, we are clicking over the social media and we are giving authority, all the authorities all the accessibility of your system means you are allowing them to access all your photographs, all your videos, as well as all your location perspective. So all these are not a secure practices. Okay, basically if you are allowing somebody or some app to do so, they may look towards your credentials basically. Okay, so insecure interfaces and APIs. So these are some remediations regarding this point. Means use a good security model of software interfaces. Next, practice a strong authentication method and limit access with encrypted transmissions. Okay, and use standard API frameworks. Means you should choose this standard API frameworks to adopt if you are running an app over that. Means if you are having some app regarding this cloud service. Okay, so you should choose standard API framework regarding that. Next is system vulnerability. What is system? System is basically combination of input, process and output. Okay, so security breaches may occur due to exploitable bugs in the program that stay within the system. Okay, so this allows a bad actor to infiltrate and get access to sensitive information or crash the service operation. Okay, so basically to avoid system vulnerability, you need to continuously check your system. Okay, and if you found any vulnerability or weakness or some point or some bugs over there, so you may immediately take corrective actions, okay, that are desired for your system. Okay, so customer access grants must be implemented using a need to know or need to access protocol. Okay, next is organizations must regularly detect data assessment and system disclosure alteration or destruction. So privilege should be separated between business as usual system level access or encrowded credential access for sensitive root or system accounts. Okay, so frequent check of quality and integrity of system as well as services means you need to frequently check your security aspect of your system. Okay, and if you found any vulnerability over there, you should immediately rectify it or should take the preventive measures to mitigate the impact of such type of vulnerability. Okay. Next is account or service hijacking means using the stolen password. Okay, so account or service hijacking can be done to gain access and abuse highly privileged accounts. So attack methods like fraud, phishing and exploitation of software vulnerability are carried out mostly using the stolen password. Okay, so what are the remedial action regarding this while you are getting hijacked or your password has been stolen? So use the strong two-factor authentication technique where possible. What is two-factor authentication? Means like Apache is there or some other mechanism are there, like you may login through your OTP, like using your phone, mobile phone or email ID. So that is basically two-factor authentication. There should be three-factor authentication, or you should have some key questions also, so that whenever you got such type of activity, means whenever your password has been stolen or your services has been hijacked, then you can change your password and safeguard yourself. So use strong two-factor authentication technique. where possible. The organization needs to take proper steps to verify identity, restrict access, and maintain adherence to industry standards and compliance. Okay, so these are some of the remedial action that you should take in while dealing with such type of activity, means account or service hijacking or using your stolen password. Next is malicious insider. That type of threat is much more prevalent nowadays. Okay, so if you are having a malicious insider that can access the sensitive data of the system administrator or may even get control over the cloud services at greater level with little or no risk of detection. Okay, so a malicious insider may affect an organization through brand damage, financial impact, and productivity loss. So for that, what should be the remedial action? These are some suggested recommendations, like remediations. Okay, like organizations must understand the practices performed by cloud providers and how to grant access to employee and set compliance policies. Means you should provide the limited accessibility to your employees. Okay, and set the compliance policies over there, so that you could have a check over your employees. Okay, so there should be security and privacy awareness program to understand, recognize, and report any suspicious activity. Means if somebody or some of your employees indulge such type of malicious activities, okay, so you can identify it and you can take the preventive action. So you should install security and privacy awareness program to understand, recognize, and report any suspicious activity. Okay, next is organizations should automate their processes and use technologies that scan frequently for misconfiguration resources and remediate unknown activity in real time. Okay, so you should go for automation whether dealing with your employees. Okay, so you should choose this automation, automate their processes and use technologies that scan frequently for misconfigured resources and remediate unknown activity. Okay, so these are some of the remediations regarding this malicious insider. Next type of threat is this data loss. So what is data loss? Basically, the data loss threat occurs in cloud due to interaction with risk within the cloud or architectural characteristics of the cloud applications. Okay, so unauthorized parties may access data to delete or alter record of an organization. Generally, competitors are involving in such type of activity, means they may sense, or like I have told you that nowadays we are using chatbots. Okay, so some dummy chatbots or phishing activities are there, and by that they are accessing all your sensitive information and using it for monetization. So what is basically this is data loss. Okay, so what are the remediation? Means cloud service providers should provide adequate security control to customers, as well as specify backups and retention strategies to them. Okay, and what should be another measures that you should adopt, like use strong API access control and encrypt security of data in transit, so that you could not lose any data in between, means in transit as well as in your organization. Okay, next is lack of due diligence. Okay, so what is this due diligence? Means most cloud providers develop a good strategy for due diligence when evaluating cloud technologies. Okay, so enterprises that choose providers without analyzing the technologies and due diligence expose of it, okay, and expose themselves to risk. So basically, what are the remediations? Organization must know what certifications the cloud provider itself has in place. Means you should doubly check your cloud vendor while dealing with means while finalizing SLA or while finalizing that cloud provider. Okay, so check over the standard of cloud vendor as well as certifications. Okay, Next is clear protocols must be defined related to accountability and responsibility of management support and environment. Okay, and use strong multi-factor password, password with multi-factor authentication tokens. So these are some of the remedial action regarding this lack of due diligence. Okay, next is abuse or nefarious use of cloud services. So this threat refers to the attackers leveraging the resources of cloud computing to target users, enterprises, and other cloud providers. Examples include launching the distributed denial of service attack, email spams, get access to credential databases, and more. Okay, so for such type of activity, for mitigating the impact of such type of activity, here are the list of some remedies against these. Okay, so this is what organization must use: strong IDs and IPs. Okay, next is this organization must use firewalls that can inspect incoming and outgoing traffic, and the integration of cloud services must not be left up to individuals or groups for implementation. An organization must choose their storage vendors wisely. The process must be corporate IT and security team only. Okay, so these are some of the recommendations or remedies that you should do, you should take to avoid such type of activities like abuse or nefarious use of cloud services. Okay, similarly, the next threat or next threat associated with the cloud provider is cloud providers deliver their services by sharing applications or infrastructure, or sometimes the components that make up the infrastructure for cloud technology as a service offerings are not designed to offer strong isolation properties for a multi-tenant cloud service. Like nowadays, many of the companies are providing shared web hosting. Okay, so what is shared web hosting is you are owning more than two means multiple, you are owning multiple websites. Okay, over there. So in that case, if you are if you have not designed proper isolation properties, in that case you will feel such type of problem is shared technology vulnerability. So this may lead to vulnerability in shared technology that can be attacked in almost all delivery models. Okay, so what are the remediations? Sensitive data should be protected via encryption. Okay, means if your data is highly confidential or sensitive, you should go for private cloud model. Okay, not adopt such type of public cloud. Okay, so sensitive data should be protected via encryption, or during transit you should use cryptographic technique. Data should be segmented and protected according to sensitivity level, and organizations must conduct vulnerability scanning and configuration audits regularly. Okay, so these are some of the remedial actions that you should take while dealing with this shared technology. Okay, so that you could safeguard your data regarding such type of vulnerability. Okay, so this is all about various types of this cyber threats in cloud computing. So if you have any query or doubt, you may ask.